Good morning, Rebels. Today is Friday, February 9th, 2018, and this is Rebel TV.
Good morning, Rebels. My name is Ryan Rodriguez. I'm a senior here at Savanna High School. Would you please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance? With your right hand over your heart, ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, Rebels. You may now be seated.
Interested in performing in Sociedad's Champurrado Night? Do you sing, dance, play an instrument, or another special talent? Anyone is welcome to perform during this event. Stop by Route 62 for more details. To find another risk, I'm contending to outer space. To find another risk, I'm gonna send it to outer space.
Juniors and seniors, are you interested in being a part of the 2018 Prom Fashion Show? Stop by Room 8 on Wednesday, February 14th, 2018, during lunch to sign up and get more information.
Mechistas, we have a meeting today, Friday, at lunch in the auditorium. See you soon.
Attention all freshmen, Freshman Field Day is Friday, February 16th. Turn in permission slips signed by your third and fourth teachers to Ms. Hoffman in Room 47 or to your English teacher no later than Wednesday, February 14th. Don't miss out on this fun event.
Good morning. Today is the last day of National School Counseling Week. We'd like to give a huge shout out to all the counseling staff here at Savanna. The school counseling staff, like everyone in our school, is here to make a difference in your life. Their doors are always open. Today we would like to highlight Ms. Rockwell and Ms. Mata. Together they are responsible for students with last names O to Z, the ROP program, and as military license. Nothing is too big or small for them. Thank you for celebrating National School Counseling Week with us. Have a terrific and a safe 3-day weekend.
Ever thought of working on tanks, aircrafts, jets, submarines? Even 3D printers are an everyday part of the Military Corps manufacturing team. Moreover, the military will pay for medical training and for your living expenses while you go to school, and you are guaranteed a job after graduation. The Military Club brings in the Army, Navy, Air Force, and Marine Corps to give interested students a sneak peek into all that's available in the armed forces as a career. Come join the conversation on Tuesdays in Room 907.
Attention Leos, please come to room 904 this Friday at lunch to talk about details for upcoming cabinet position.
Attention Rebels, the applications for the student exchange program are due by 5 p.m. on Wednesday, February 28th. This year's destination is Mito, Japan. You must fall into the application requirements in order to be eligible, so apply now. Only 6 high school students from the city of Anaheim will be selected by the Anaheim Sister City Commission. You can pick up your application today at the Student Center.
Black Student Union is having a fundraiser at Raising Cane's in Orange on February 13th from 12 p.m. to 10 p.m. Be sure to mention Black Student Union when making an order so some of the proceeds can go to the club. Also, Friday is the last day for t-shirt and hoodie sales. Please talk to any Black Student Union board member to purchase one.
The boys' Frost Shop soccer team played a tough game against Catella on Thursday and finished their season with a tie score 2-2. Goals were scored by Kevin Mendoza and Javier Rodriguez. The JV team defeated Catella with Oscar Beltran scoring 3 goals with the hat trick and giving them the title of Orange League champs. Way to go, guys. The varsity boys played excellent soccer game but came up just short, 2-1. Thank you for all your support and we look forward to seeing you out again this year.
Congratulations to the varsity boys basketball team, who last night defeated Catella in a nail-biter by a score of 63-60. With the victory, the Rebels secured a tie for first place in Orange League, their 8th consecutive league title. Great job, guys! Yesterday, Savanna alum Trevor Hoffman, class of 1985, visited his alma mater to visit with the baseball team and share his experiences as an 18-year veteran of Major League Baseball. Hoffman, along with his brother, were the first inductees into Savannah's Hall of Fame, and just 2 weeks ago, Trevor was inducted into Major League's Hall of Fame. Congratulations, Trevor, and you're welcome to stop by anytime.
I got my ticket for the long way.
Good morning, Rebels! Happy Friday! What a week we have had. I want to start out by thanking you all as we move forward and we reflect on the week. The week started out on Monday, obviously, with a WAS visit team. I want to share what the WAS team said about you guys. She said, "You Rebels are kind, compassionate, and family-oriented. You are so family-centered as well. And I want to give you a big thank you, a big shout-out, for the way you carry yourselves and just for being yourselves on a daily basis. And I really appreciate that. And I see it every day. And I'm just thankful that the team got to see it as well. I want to thank you also for continuing to keep the campus clean. I'm a clean freak and I like to keep it clean like a washing machine. And I want you to continue picking up after yourselves like you do. However, we have had an uptick in tagging and graffiti on campus. I take that really personal. And we do too, and we take it seriously. So please, some things to keep in mind as we move forward. Keeping it clean like the washing machine, like I said, let's do that.
Permanent markers are a no-go. You can receive discipline for permanent markers. Tagging on campus is serious. If caught tagging on campus, you will have discipline. Could be led to transfer, expulsion, and up to a $500 fine. So we take it serious. Think of this place as your home, and as much as we do as well. Another big thing that happened this week is we had over 63 pints of blood donated at the blood drive this week on Tuesday. That's an amazing amount of blood. So I really appreciate those of you that stepped up and donated and gave back to the community and helped out somebody else. Also, sports. This was the last week of the Orange League. Man, it was an exciting week of sports, even up until last night. Our boys basketball in a grueling battle with Catella back and forth all night long, won the game and secured a three-way tie championship for the league. So congratulations, boys basketball. It was so great. The turnout was amazing last night. They'll move on next week in playoffs. Girls soccer on Wednesday won as well to secure a third place finish, and they'll go on to the playoffs as well. And girls water polo finished second earlier in the week, and they will play next Tuesday as we move forward in postseason play. So congratulations to all Rebels out there. I also want to say 2 weeks ago, we welcomed 12 students from China, and they've had a great experience. I hope you've had a chance to get to know them. I sure have. And today is their final day. So as we said, welcome the last week, today we say goodbye. We've enjoyed their stay. We wish them nothing but the best. And I'm so glad that us Rebels got to show them what American school looks like. I'm really proud of you all. So thank you so much for your time, your effort, your patience, your compassion, and have a great weekend.
That'll be it for today's announcements, Rebels. Have a fascinating Friday.